Thrombi can develop anywhere in the cardiovascular system, for example, in cardiac chambers, on valves, or in arteries, veins, or capillaries. The site and shape is depend on the site of origin and the cause. Morphology of thrombus. Thrombi can have apparent laminations called lines of dam. This is a mixed thrombus with lamination structure, pale area alternated with red area. In pale area, there are platelets and fibrin. In red area, there are erythrocytes. Here also showed lamination. Laminations represent pale platelets and fibrin layers alternating with darker erythrocyte-rich layers. According to the location of thrombus, it includes arterial thrombi, venous thrombi, mural thrombi, and vegetation. Arterial thrombi typically begin at site of endothelial injury or turbulence, such as trauma, vasculitis, atherosclerotic plaque. This shows thrombus in coronary artery. Under microscope, it is a mixed thrombus containing platelets and fibrin, erythrocytes, and degenerating leukocytes to form a gray-white friable meshwork. Venous thrombi occur at sites of stasis, most occurred in veins of lower extremities, nearly 90%. Here, this is a red thrombus. Thrombus is occlusive and appeared as a long cast of vein lumen. Cross observation, it is dark red, moist, and elastic. It is fleshy. Under microscope, the main component of the red venous thrombus is erythrocytes. Of course, also includes some platelets and fibrin. Mural thrombi may occur in heart chambers or in aortic lumen. The common causes may be myocardial infarction, ulcerated atherosclerotic plaques, and aneurysmal dilation. This shows cardiac mural thrombi. It has backgrounds of myocardial infarction, thrombus in the left and right ventricular abysses, overlying white fibrous scar. Vegetations, it is pale thrombus. Thrombi on heart valves are called vegetations. It contains bacterial or non-bacterial vegetations. Here, it is pneumatic endocarditis, small pale vegetations distributed along the lines of closure of the mitral valve leaflet. It is firm, not easy to fall off. It is non-bacterial vegetation. This is infective endocarditis. Here, we can see friable vegetations on the mitral valve. It is bacterial vegetation. Fate of the thrombus. 1. Propagation. Thrombi accumulate additional platelets and fibrin, eventually causing vessel obstruction. 2. Dissolution. Thrombi are removed by fibrinolytic activity, maybe total lysis in fresh thrombi, or in completely dissolved in older thrombi. 3. Embolization. Thrombi dislodge or fragment are transported elsewhere in the vasculature. 4. Organization and recanalization. Organization. Thrombi induce inflammation, fibrosis, and formation of granulation tissue. Recanalization. Organized thrombi can eventually re-establish some degree of flow, or they can be incorporated into a thickened vessel wall, thus maintain the continuity of the original lumen. This is a normal artery. This is an artery with an old thrombus. The original lumen is totally filled with organized thrombus. Finally, the new capillary channels were formed to maintain the continuity of the original lumen. We call this as recanalization. This is an artery with an old thrombus, also with organization and recanalization. Three small lumens are new established capillary channels to maintain the continuity of the original lumen. Now, let's summarize the fate of thrombus. Propagation, dissolution, embolization, organization, and recanalization. Clinical correlation of thrombi. Thrombi are important for two reasons. 1. Cause arterial or venous obstructed. Provide possible source of emboli. The effect of thrombosis is dependent on its site. As for venous thrombosis, it may cause congestion and edema and has capacity to embolize to the lungs and cause death. Most venous thrombi arise in either the superficial or the deep veins of the leg. Arterial and cardiac thrombosis. Consequences. Arterial obstruction embolizes to brain, kidney, and spleen because of their large volume of blood flow. This is a coronary atherosclerosis. This is a coronary atherosclerosis with an old thrombosis. The lumen of the vessels is obstructed by the thrombus. Disseminated intravascular coagulation, we call DIC. DIC is an acute, subacute, or chronic thrombohemorrhagic disorder. It occurs as a secondary complication in a variety of underlying diseases. These diseases may include tissue factors or thromboplastic substance release, or injuring the endothelial cells widespreadly. The characteristic of DIC is thrombohemorrhagic disorder. First feature, because of coagulation system activation, microthrombi, also called fibrin thrombi, formed throughout the microcirculation. Second feature, fibrin and coagulation factors are consumed. Secondarily, fibrinitic system are activated. And finally, hemorrhagic disorder take place. Microscope. Fibrin thrombi within microcirculation may be identified in any tissue, mostly in kidney glomeruli. Here shows fibrin thrombi in glomerular capillary. This shows fibrin thrombi in capillaries of lung, the consequence of DIC, thrombi resulting tissue hypoxia and microinfarct shock, multi-organ dysfunction. Make a summary. As for hemostasis and thrombosis, endothelial cells, platelets, and coagulation system all play important roles. Endothelial injury, abnormal blood flow, that stasis or turbulence, hypercoagulability are vessel triad for thrombogenesis. In the end, thrombi may propagate, dissolve, embolize, and organize and recognize.